Hi there! I've created this video special for you who wants to know what is WordPress. Maybe one of your children told you, I'm gonna build a website with WordPress. Or maybe one of your colleagues said, well, we could just simply use a WordPress website. And you were like, yeah, that sounds cool, I know what a website is, but what is WordPress? This video is all about answering that question. Hi, I am the WordPress Doctor. I've been building WordPress websites since 2004. I have my own national hosting company and my web development agency, so I definitely know what WordPress is. Let's get started with the beginning. WordPress is a content management system. What is that? It's a software where you get, that you can use. It's a program on your computer which you can use to build a website. A content management. You can manage your content on your website. That is what WordPress is. The good news is WordPress is totally free. It is open source. It means that everyone in the world can create stuff to use in your WordPress website to make it better, to enhance it, and to create new stuff other people didn't thought about. So WordPress is this great system you can use to build your website. Now, how does this work? WordPress has an interface which you can install WordPress on your server. You need a server, that's a computer somewhere in the world where your website files are stored. Now, when you type in your domain name like wpressdoctor.com, you go to this server, you connect to this other computer, and this other computer will show you the things that I have built on this website using WordPress as a tool to build all those images, text and files and all the styles and all the format, and you'll see all those things that I've created inside of WordPress. So far, so good, right? Now, let's dive in a little bit deeper, because within WordPress you can build anything you want. It's not just a system to create blogs, you know, text with images above it. No. WordPress has grown into this gigantic website you can build anything with. You can even build your own e-commerce website where you can sell stuff to people. You get a notification, people can pay you using WordPress. It's all in this system. But how does that work? Well, WordPress itself is just a system that has no styles or anything to it. So you would need a theme, that's how it's called, a theme. You can just lay it over WordPress so people will see the theme. Now this theme usually will give you some extra functionalities to add things to WordPress. So you can expand your website with all kinds of things like images, like different kind of styles of the menu on top of your website. You can all change that by using a different theme. Also, WordPress has more than 10,000 themes available and 4,000 of them are completely free. So that's really awesome. If you want to know how that all works, I've created a video especially how to install WordPress and how to build a website in just 10 minutes and 4 simple steps. The link is in the description below, so you can just click it and watch that video if you want to know how. So you have these themes, but you also have plugins. Now, plugins are a little pieces of software that you put into your WordPress system so that you can expand the functionality of your WordPress website. Using this, you can create an e-commerce website where you can sell anything you like, for example. Also, you can use this to speed up your WordPress website. Also, you can use plugins for, well, if you want a special image gallery that your theme doesn't support, you can download a plugin and you can place it into your WordPress website. Most of the times, those themes and those plugins are completely free. That's the good news. On the other hand, if you want special things, really great coded things that are really awesome, the most companies charge you a little bit of money for those plugins or those themes. It's not like you pay thousands of euros, thousands of dollars, thousands of yens. No, it is very easy. You just pay like $50 or $20 or something in that price range, because there are just little snippets of code that you place into little pieces of software that you place into your WordPress website. Now you know the basics of WordPress. It's a content management system where you can place anything in it. That's easy, right? So I'm gonna take you to the back side of the website and show you when you log into WordPress, how does it all work. It will not be a tutorial about how to create your own website, but I'll just walk you through all the things in WordPress so you have an idea how it's supposed to work and that you can make a choice if you want to choose WordPress or choose another content management system out there to build your website. But, well, I am the WordPress doctor and I've been building websites since 2004 in WordPress and 2001 with other kinds of systems, and I gotta tell you, WordPress is way out the best. As from now, 33% of the websites in the top 10 million websites in the world are built with WordPress. That says enough because WordPress is such a great system. Now, come on, I'll show you the backside of WordPress. So welcome to the backside of WordPress. This is a typical login page of WordPress. Once you have entered your credentials, you can log in. Welcome to the WordPress dashboard. It is the same with every WordPress installation. Of course, you can tweak it, you can style it, you can change it, but this is the place where you always start. On the left side, we have the big menu with all the things that WordPress has to offer you. And you have on the far top, you have the WordPress branded menu. You have your own WordPress website. When I click this, I will go to my website. This is for all the discussion and the comments added to your website. And this is to create something new. So you see on the left side is the WordPress menu. You can see these four options are for your content of your WordPress website, and these options are for the settings and creating the layout of your website and the functionalities of your website. Well, of course, we have updates. When you click on this, you will go to the WordPress updates section, and here you can always update your plugins and your themes and WordPress itself. As I mentioned before, you have WordPress, you have your plugins, and you have your themes. Let's go to posts. When you create posts, you will have them here. You can create blog posts, video posts, everything you would like. So this is the media library. This is the place where all of your photos, videos, and images, and everything you have uploaded through your website will be added to here. So you can use them when editing your posts or your pages. You can sort them by type, or you can sort them by date, or you can easily search here for the right file you're looking for. So these are the pages. Here you can build your front page, your home page, your contact page, all the pages you would love to create. There's something here, so that's pretty awesome. Let's go to the next one, it's comments, and in the comments section you will find all the comments that have been added to your pages or posts in your WordPress website. Here you can change them, add them, delete them, mark them as spam or whatever. So let's go to the settings of WordPress. First you have the appearance. At the appearance tab you can choose your themes, for example. Remember I told you about themes? Well, this is the standard 2020 theme of WordPress, which is shipped in with WordPress installation. But I would really recommend the best theme in the world, which is Divi. If you want to know more about Divi, you can follow the link in the description or check out my other videos, how to create a Divi website in just 10 minutes. So from the themes, this is the customizer, where you can customize your website. This is the place where you can add widgets or something, new functionalities to your footer or sidebar or whatever your theme creates here. This is the place where you have your menu. You can build your menu here. It's just a drag and drop. You can just, this is your homepage, portfolio, about, contact. You can just add them here like this and you can place them in your menu. It's really simple, really easy. You save this menu and your menu will be placed on the front end of your website. Here's the background, where you can change the background of the 2020 theme, which is active right now. The theme editor. So WordPress is giving you here a heads up, because you have to know when you edit these files in the code, then you can break stuff. So don't do this. You have to press go back. And if you want to make changes to your theme,
then you should create a WordPress child theme. I've made a simple and short video about that, how to add a WordPress child theme to your website in just 60 seconds. It is that easy. So these are the plugins that are already installed on your WordPress website, and here is the place where you can add new ones. You can search for plugins like this, or if you already have a plugin, if you bought one, you can add it here. So you can edit it here and install it now. Of course, you also have, for the theme editor, there comes a plugin editor, and WordPress is also warning you, do not change these files, because when you change this, things will break. So we go to users, and the users is the place where you can add all users that have access to the backend of your web's WordPress website. This is the place where you can add other users, and this is very awesome because you can give them certain roles. So the administrator is the guy who can do everything, but if you want someone only to add content like this, you can add a new person and give him only the role of editor or author, contributor or subscriber. You can do anything with this one. So this is an awesome feature of WordPress. Then we have the tools. The tools section is really awesome because here you can export everything you want to another website, for example. So we have the import-export, and of course we have the site health. This has been added in the newest version of WordPress, and this is the place where you can check what you should do to get your site, your WordPress website, in great health. Now they have recommend improvements, remove plugins and inactive themes. This is a very good thing to do because it is a security vulnerability. So you should remove these, and of course you can also see what kind of version you have, what your performance is of your web server and all the security settings. So this is really awesome. Here you can export personal data when you have a lot of subscribers, for instance, or for example a lot of comments and people registered to your website. When they email you, you have to remove them, and this is the place where you can do that. So when you go to the general settings of your website, you will see all these things that you can change, like your title, your tagline, your WordPress address, your website address, and everything there is, from your site language to your time zones, date formats and time formats, and when you want to start the week. So you can change anything you want in these settings. Let's go to the writing settings. Here you can see the default post category and post format. And if you would like to mail something to your WordPress website that it will be instantly published, you can use this little service. Let's go to reading. Here you can change what your home page displays, your latest post or a static page. I have a static page right now for the home page. And you can change your blog page shows, your syndicate feeds and all these things. Let's go to the next one, discussion. This is the place where you can change the settings of all the members. What can they do? Can they post a comment on your post, or can't they do that? And this is if you want to receive emails. This is just all everything about the discussion settings. We have the media settings, what to do when you upload images to your website. They will be automatically changed also through the thumbnails, medium size and large size. This is the place where you can change your permalinks. If you don't change it, your website will be like this. WordPress.com/?? Page is 123 and all the IDs, the numbers of your pages. I always say change this to post name, because this is the best setting for your website and for SEO. Of course, you have the privacy, and here is your privacy policy page. You should create this page, note to self, so that people know your privacy policy.
Now you know what WordPress is and how it works on a beginner's level. Of course, we can dive into the sea of WordPress, swim with the sharks, with the dolphins, and have a lot of fun. And I am doing that on my YouTube channel. But for now, you know how it works. You can also translate your WordPress website into different languages. You can do many, many, many things. The sky is the limit. So as I mentioned before, in the description, there's a link which you can press so you can learn how to build your own WordPress website in just 10 minutes in 4 simple and easy steps. Yes, it is that simple to get started. So if you want to know more and if I helped you out with this video, press that like button, and also you can hit that subscribe button to know more and get a notification when I upload a new video. All right, I wish you a very awesome day, and if you hang tight, I will give you another life-changing quote, because life is more than just building WordPress websites.
Because life is more than building WordPress website, here is the quote of the day. And the quote is from Albert Einstein. This is what he said: everything that is truly great and inspiring is created by the individual that could labor in freedom. Give yourself the time and freedom to be creative. Discover what your best creative time is, not your productivity time, but your creativity time. Know when it is and go labor in that in your freedom, because that is where dreams and big ideas are born. Have an awesome day. Good luck.